Lord, praise God for the spirit we felt. Lord, praise God for the souls that were saved. And praise God for your dedications. And I just want to praise God for being God last night. It wasn't about the preacher, it wasn't about the scene, but God just showed up. So I just want to thank you for staying with me tonight. We're just going to beg God to do the same thing tonight. We're going to let the Holy Spirit know He's welcome here. I'm going to beg you to go right ahead.
Come.
much in prayer for him tonight. We've got a couple announcements tonight. This Saturday night at 7 o'clock, in revival, just to kind of bridge the gap for us to keep going. This Saturday night at 7 o'clock, we're going to have a Josh Scout come and share his testimony. Just a small little worship service, nothing real long, that's the Lord allows. And after that, we'll head over to the Life Center with pizza and food and drinks. So I'm going to make that announcement about Saturday. We kind of want to make that a one-day crusade, too. We're going to make that all about the lost, bring as many people as you can to hear Brother Josh's testimony. It's unbelievable. And second thing, if you want a DVD of any service this week, we've got a sign-up sheet in the back. Just put your name, your number, and whatnot you want. And also, the services are going to be on live recorded on Facebook as well on YouTube. So you can find it that way. But tonight we're going to hand it over to Amy. We're just going to pray to the Lord.
Amen. All right, guys, we're going to sing an old one but a good one. Turn the page number 317 in your hymnals. If you can, sing Victory in Jesus. We have victory through Him today.
Precious was the tone.
end on tonight. Any prayer requests tonight? Any prayer requests tonight? Amen. Let's pray for Brother Joel tonight. He's got Parkinson's disease. You believe God's greater than Parkinson's disease? Amen. We're going to pray over our brother later at the end of the service there. Y'all remember him in prayer? Yes, sir.
Yeah, I'd like to keep our nation in our prayer. Our nation needs our prayer.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Anybody else?
Brother Hunter, Lord, don't intervene. You just a couple of months. I've had some pretty serious surgery. That's all.
Anybody else?
Yeah.
persecuted.
Lord, excuse me.
Anybody else that I've heard before?
Thank you. Our God. The Spirit of God.
beginning of service. Let's fill that loose. Anybody got a testimony tonight?
Thank you, Scott.
Thank you.
Bible.
This nation is in need of revival. This county is in need of revival. And we're not doing a thing about it. The Burlington revival didn't happen overnight. Brother Randy Hoff prayed for 10 years. For 10 years, Randy Hoff prayed to see revival. 10 years he begged and waited for God to see the revival. And it took 10 years.
was tired of going to church.
Amen.
Not for
anything.
He was tired of going to church. He's going through the motions.
Amen.
You say, preacher, what was all that about? Somebody's going to God to use
it. Amen.
Somebody needs God to use
it. Amen.
I don't know what the Lord has in store. I don't know what I'm supposed to do next. I don't know what it's supposed to do. I don't want it. But God's not going to let me get out of it. This isn't a message that I prefer to preach. I've known about it for ever since Tyrell texted me and told me about you. This is what God laid on my heart. And it's not a pleasant message to preach. It's not a happy message to preach. But it's a message that God has given me to preach, thus saith the Lord. I don't want anyone to do it. Just going to be mindful of God. If you have your Bibles tonight, turn to the book of Luke, chapter number 16. The book of Luke, chapter number 16. Verse number 19, we're going to have you place if you can stand. I ask you to pray for me. I heard a preacher one time that said, don't pray for me while I'm up there preaching. About halfway through the service, he was begging me to pray for me. Because I can't do this without God. When you found your place, the Bible says, Book of Luke, chapter 16, verse 19. There was a certain rich man, which was clothed in purple and fine linen, and fared sumptuously every day.
Amen.
There was a certain beggar named Lazarus, which was laid in his gate full of sores, and desiring to be fed with the crumbs which fell from the rich man's table. Moreover, the dogs came and licked his sores up. And it came to pass that the beggar died, and was carried the rich man also died and was buried. Look, church. And in hell, he lifted up his eyes, being in torments, and seeing Abraham afar off, and Lazarus in his bosom. And he cried and said, Father Abraham, have mercy on me. And send Lazarus that he may dip the tip of his finger in water and cool my tongue, for I am tormented in the flame. But Abraham said, Son, remember that thou in thy lifetime receivest thy good things, and likewise Lazarus evil things. But now he is comforted, and thou art tormented. Beside all this, between us and you there is a great gulf fixed, so that they which would pass from hence to you cannot, neither can they pass to us that would come from thence. Then he said, I pray thee therefore, Father, that thou wouldest send him to my father's house. For I have five brethren that he may testify to them, lest they also come into his place of torment. Abraham said unto him, and they have Moses and the prophets, let them hear them. And he said, nay, Father Abraham, what if one went unto them from the dead, they would repent? And he said unto him, if they hear not Moses and the prophets, neither will they be persuaded, though one rose from the dead.
Luke. When I began to study, I found out Luke 12, you have the parable of the rich fool. In 1:16, where we're at, you have the rich man Lazarus. And in Luke 18, you have the rich young ruler. But I found out that these rich men were not the same men. They were different men. The rich men were not the same in one, they were different. This particular text out of the book of Luke, the rich man and Lazarus is not a parable. You'll find that the rich man and Lazarus is not a parable. The rich parable does not mention its character by name. So we don't have a parable here. We have a story that was written from the pages of a young man. And was placed in this book for the world to listen. And it's not a delightful story. But I'm telling you tonight, this story is not uncommon. This story is not uncommon. That rich man would die and go to hell. Because he lost more of his earthly things.
Yeah.
But you also see people
Yes, you are.
I remember it like it was yesterday.
Bless you.
I don't know if my family paid attention or not, but I did. I remembered it like it was yesterday. But you see, this rich man had everything he could have wanted.
Yeah.
He had everything he needed. He didn't have to worry about where his next meal come from.
Bless you.
He didn't have to worry about where his clothes came from. And if you put it in modern time, he was buying all the Patagonia, and he was buying all the Aeropostale and Abercrombie, and the Southern Tide, and all this. He had all that, Richard.
Yeah.
He wasn't looking for it. He wasn't asking somebody to buy it for it. He had it. Lazarus was sick, had sores all about his body. The rich man never paid attention. Verse number 22. And it came to pass that the beggar died and was carried by the angels into Abraham's
bosom.
The rich man also died and was buried. So now you see that these two men that we have. Verse 19, 20, and 21 and both died. Doesn't say how the rich man died. I just know that he died. It could have been a sudden death. I believe that the rich man died a sudden death. I don't believe he was born. I don't believe he was born. I don't believe he was sick. He said he fared sumptuously every day. So I don't believe he was sick. I believe that the rich man that day just went about his life like he did any other day. But he died.
Yeah.
And now look where he ends up.
God. God.
Verse 23. And in hell.
Bless you.
In hell.
Bless you.
He lifted up his eyes.
Yes,
so now you see that this rich man who had everything he ever wanted. But a life that was going to be full of torment and misery day in and day out for the rest of his life. All those things that he had while he was on earth, he didn't take them with him. He couldn't take them with him to hell. When he died and went to hell, that was it. He had no more chances. He had no more opportunities. He didn't have any more dreams. He died, and everything that he had on earth stayed. So now I see that Lazarus is in Abraham's bosom.
Yeah.
And I see that the rich man is in hell.
Right.
I see that the rich man has died, but yet he sees Lazarus in Abraham's bosom. So he died, but he can still see. He died, but he can still feel.
Yeah.
He died, but he can still hear. All that did for this rich man was strip him of his earthly body. That's all that did for this rich man. It stripped him of his earthly body. You see that the rich man is now in torment. And you see him now in misery. Send Lazarus that he may dip the tip of his finger in water and
That was all the introduction.
The help.
I want to preach on this thought.
It turns. It's too late.
Where do you want to spend eternity?
Where's the place?
Well, put that question in your mind. Where are you going to spend eternity? When I read this message, it doesn't scare me.
I'm lost.
Thank you.
that way.
Amen.
He made it so simple.
Yeah,
but we make it so hard.
That's it, God.
Amen.
Whosoever. Say, no, preacher, that ain't me. Well, you're mistaken.
Amen.
Because that's what
bullets that hit the rich man. No warnings was given. He didn't have another second to try and make things right. You and I are here to promise that other opportunity. One time, Hebrews 9:27, and as it is appointed unto man once to die, but after this, the judgment. You and I are going to die one day. That's one thing I'm sure of.
Yeah.
Is that you and I are going to die. Whether it be by the grave or by the rapture, we're leaving this world alive. And after that, just. During that day, we will say, Lord, Lord, if we not lost time.
Amen.
Many will be there that day saying, Lord, didn't you see me in Sunday school that one time? God, didn't you see me walk that aisle that one time? Didn't you see me stand and sing in the choir that one time? I gave $1 when the offering plate passed around. That's got me for something. I went up there and prayed around that young man when he was sick. That's got to count for something. I'm sorry,
but it's
hard. Bless you've been saved by the blood of Christ.
Yes.
We'll hear the words. Depart from me.
Yeah.
Thy works of me. For I
am.
And at that moment, you'll be cast in the hell. You'll be cast. Which is the second day. I wonder tonight how many times some of you have told no. And I wonder if the last time he spoke to you might be the last. If that be the case, you had your chance. And I pray, Lord, have mercy on me. Come by your way when your time before it's eternally too late. Because you end up in the same place the rich man get rid of. It's where they'll end up. They'll know Jesus, that's where they're going. They'll find themselves in the same place the rich man did. He cried for mercy. He was denied. Because it was too late. It had his opportunity. And he said no. The last time. I heard a story one time in close. All of you would have come. I heard a story one time of a preacher that was pastoring a church. There was a certain family in that church. It was a mother and a father and a 17-year-old boy. That young boy was raised in church. Never missed a Sunday unless something that had come up. Never missed a Wednesday unless something come up. He never asked if they were going to church or not. He said, yeah. Much like I was raised. But this 17-year-old boy didn't know who God was. And the preacher said for a week, he said under Holy Ghost conviction. You've been in those services, have you ever seen the Holy Ghost conviction said on someone? So here. And they're so bothered, they never moved. This 17-year-old boy said for a week for Bible. Under Holy Ghost conviction. And he said no. And he said no. He said no. Until one night, after the altar call was given, the young man said, the entire service couldn't sit still, couldn't stop sweating. You think you're talking here tonight?
Mm-hmm.
weeping. Because they knew once again it would fall out of them. They pulled out of the parking lot of the church and a tractor and trailer hit them in the side. That car flipped and it flipped. This is a true story, church. I'm not telling you this just to scare you.
Bless the Lord.
That car flipped and it flipped. That moment that he was thrown to the car without a scratch, without even a bruise, but that 17-year-old boy was trapped under it. He was still inside the backseat of the car and was trapped. This young man had his whole life ahead of him. And he played sports, he had all kinds of friends. He had his whole life ahead of him. Till that night, the gas was pouring out of the car, Richard said. Said he seen the whole thing. Said that gas was pouring out of the car. Said it caught flames. Said that young woman was in the back seat of screaming. Please, just cry out to him to save him. And he said,
a Christian get killed.
Yes.
Twice. It was selfish enough.
Thank you. Oh,
in and say, Richard, I got things all right tonight. I've got peace in my soul.
Yes,
yeah. I've got peace in my soul.
Yes, Doctor. Hey, man.
I've done what the Lord's asked me to do. I wonder tonight if you'd slip your hand up and say, Richard,
pray with God.
I've still not done what the Lord's wanted me to do. I've still not done what the Lord's wanted me to do.
Yeah.
because you said, Lord, in your word, God, we expect, God, because you know in your word, you said you're God, you cannot lie. God, we know that you keep your word. Your word is your sure, God, it'll stand. The Lord, the Bible says that the flower will fade and the grass will wither, but God, your word shall stand forever.
Yes.
God, I know, Lord, I can rely on it. God, Lord, I can base my life upon it. God, I can live by it. It's your word. God, it's your word.
Help. And he said, well, every step I take, I seem to get stronger. So I give the Lord praise. Her heart began to chest, and she walked, she came up, she bowed down, and she started singing. A miracle in the making. I thought my soul was going to bust. Because that was a confirmation from God. But just immediately, he was going to walk up and say, I'm going to do it too. And I thank God for that. And they should all be serving. And this shouldn't be out of the ordinary.
That's right.
We serve an extraordinary God. Why does this amaze us? He still makes the blind eyes to see. And the lame to walk. He can still raise the dead, carry the camel. He can still do it. I believe in it. I believe in the power of God. He can still do it. Why don't we go get more ready then? Why don't we see what God can do? Because he can. He can do that. I just thank God in the service tonight. Praise the Lord for survival. This is good stuff. God's got more.
Yes, sir.
God's got more this summer. He talked more than that before it's over.
That's right.
Praise God. I love you.
I just want to thank the Lord for that. One more time. I think all the loss has been stopped. Praise God for that. But tonight, the Lord told me to say, if you've got a problem in your life, we say, man, if you can't walk, then you walk. In your life, I want you to know God is greater than it. Tonight, as they sing, how great is our God. I want you to know God can take care of all this all. If you need to come, one last chance tonight before we close, last thing we want to do tonight, we're just going to praise God and let him know how thankful we are for him.
Thank you.
not. You got social media, you got friends, you get a hold of. There's somebody know what God did today. There's somebody know what God did today. I believe tonight in the name of Jesus Christ, greater things are yet to come.
Amen.
I believe it. If they got a word on the heart, a word of testimony, if they got to say about the book.
One more thing. Whoever got saved tonight, if you would come up here in the front, we got you a Bible to take with you if you need one. We've got Bibles back here. Whoever got saved or whoever are rededicated, we want you to just come up here and get one for you tonight.
Thank you. Oh!
In the third day, he will raise us up, and we shall be up in his sight.
Yes.
I'm going to tell what God did tomorrow.
Amen.
anybody does.
Brother Hunter, I just want to say I'm thankful, and I know I'm Stetson.
Yeah.
Devil's come against the son, you've never been taken. You've done this, you ain't done that since the son is under the blood. I'm thankful, I know what I'm ever found. No matter what this life throws at me, you know, if I get put to jail, if I get through prison, I'll pray for the Lord.
gonna call and throw off on another denomination, but hey, we've all
survived. That's right.
Yes. Now, we used to be hungry for. We need to pray. Pray.
Yes, Lord.
Tomorrow's down there. I know it's been a lot of money for us, so here's Stetson.